I don't like to waste time. I know you want to get into overclocking. I just want to put a disclaimer. Please check your parts before you overclock. Most motherboards can do it just fine, and there are certain kinds of motherboards that overclock better than others. But also, definitely check your power supply. If you have like a 300 watt power supply, do not be overclocking. While for most people this isn't an issue, just make sure that if you don't have some incredibly strong power supply, that you aren't throwing on 5 billion volts for your voltage. That out of the way, we can get started. Links to everything will be in the description below. We're gonna head over to the MSI Afterburner website. We're gonna hit download Afterburner here. There are many programs for overclocking, but MSI Afterburner is generally regarded as the best. It's the most updated. It has really great software. It has a good overlay. However, a popular alternative is definitely EVGA's precisonX. I'm gonna make a folder we can extract this into, and I'm gonna bring this to the desktop. I'm going to extract this here. I'm running version 4.4.2 in this video. While the installation process shouldn't change, if there's anything different, let me know and I'll update the video. You're just gonna go through here. Be sure to install Rivet Tuner. It's gonna give you that on-screen overlay, which looks really nice. And you're definitely gonna want this. Now it's going to create a shortcut on the desktop. Now it's gonna run the Rivet Tuner installer. So if it freezes for a second, don't worry. And then it'll just have an option to run MSI Afterburner, or you can click the shortcut it creates on the desktop. Now this is what MSI Afterburner looks like. Obviously, they change the interface every now and then, so this may look like a lot of information for you right away. However, it's not as complicated as it looks. Now this is going to say your graphics card and driver version. We are running 390.65. Again, nothing should really change between them. However, if it does, I can always make an updated video. So we're gonna hit the settings button down here. Now this thing's gonna come up. Now there's a lot of different settings you can choose in here. Is first go to fan. Now you can set a custom fan curve here. It's not a big deal. I know some people like to change it, but it's really up to you. If you're overclocking, I definitely recommend just moving it up just a tiny hair. I'm not gonna do it, but now we're gonna go to monitoring and on-screen display. So you go to here, and this is where you're gonna set up all your buttons to put on the on-screen display. I put it on my numpad. I can turn the numpad on and off so I don't mess with it in games. Then we're gonna go to monitoring. Now often these buttons on the left aren't checked. You also need to click the button down here, show in on-screen display for a GPU temperature graph. If you have a super fancy Logitech keyboard with an LCD display, yeah, you can have it on there too. Pretty cool, huh? So generally what I like to do is I like to put GPU temperature, GPU usage, because, well, evidently we are overclocking the GPU. I like to put the core clock. Probably should put the memory clock on there too. The fan speed is definitely something you should do. You can change this however you want. Now we're gonna hit OK and start overclocking. So it depends on how hard of an overclock you really want to do. If you're a beginner, you probably want to start out small. Now this interface may look confusing, but all we need to do is just realize that this kind of stuff here in the middle, core clock and memory clock, is the important stuff. So what we're gonna do, we're just going to increase the power limit a tiny bit. I'd personally like to bump it up to 105%, but it's just gonna give you that slight edge. You want to look up for your own GPU, just some general guidelines for overclocking, you know, what people are adding or putting in. But the general consensus for my GPU is that it's going to be about, I have the actual clocks right here. So you can actually save profiles in this too. If you know, you right click, you can save and delete them. So you can have multiple profiles while you're testing the stuff. So I'm going to load this profile. So yeah, this is going to be the setup I use for our benchmarks. And really, this is like a really safe overclock. You're not risking breaking your GPU or anything off of this. So basically any average Joe that just built his computer and wants to overclock their GPU can do it. And this is just basically some free performance. So we're gonna hit the check mark, and then we're gonna do a quick benchmark and see what happens. So I'm back. We just got done. I'm sure you can see by the great graphs I have on the screen that we actually got a pretty big boost from that. Just a reminder, you know, the first time I ran the benchmark, an average of about 55 FPS, you know, 55 through 60. I noticed there were some dips, so the average was 55. And in the second time we did the benchmark, the average was about 63.5. Which is literally, that's about a 15% increase in performance for free. And this wasn't even like a hard overclock. I'm sure, you know, I could probably get another 150 megahertz out of the memory, you know, even if I threw some core voltage in there. That's if you guys can get creative with it, you know, maybe even overclock your CPU. But this was, you know, just a basic overclocking. You know, anybody can do this. You could do it right now in 5 minutes, just like this video is. And you just get, like, literally an instant free 15% performance boost. Now, we all have our own reasons for overclocking. Personally, it's because while I was streaming today, link in the description and screen, I noticed on my XCOM 2, I was running at about ultra settings, was starting to lag a bit. So you can really just see how this free 15% increase can help so much because it's literally just kind of free. You know, if you're a streamer, this will help you so much. If you just want more FPS in a game like GTA 5, it's free. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Good luck overclocking. Be sure to subscribe if you want more tech videos, and be sure to like the video if this helps you. Catch y'all later.